A tiny baby in London is being hailed as Britain's youngest survivor of COVID-19. Emmanuel was born prematurely and caught the virus while on a ventilator in intensive care. Helena Humphrey spoke with his mother about his amazing recovery.
Britain's youngest COVID-19 survivor, baby Emmanuel, finally allowed home after a 47-day battle for his life. His mother, Evelyn, forever thankful to the doctors and nurses at King's College Hospital in London.
I think I was the happiest person on earth that day.
Elation after the kind of agony no parent wants to endure. Emmanuel was born 3 months premature. After surviving that, nurses then had to break the news to Evelyn that her tiny son had another battle on his hands, sepsis and COVID-19.
Seeing many of them coming, I was like, what's going on? And then one of them walked to me and then she was like, Mom, I'm sorry. Within the next 24 hours, we might lose baby Emmanuel. And I'm like, why? So I pray a bit and then I cry. It was just crying and crying and crying.
Evelyn was told by doctors here at King's College Hospital in London to prepare for the worst on 3 separate occasions. And with hope fading, those doctors turned to a drug called remdesivir, tested unsuccessfully for Ebola patients, using it on baby Emmanuel on compassionate grounds.
At a time when trials of the drug for COVID patients are still ongoing, it was a risk.
It was a tricky decision to make because this is the first time we used it. We were not aware of side effects at such a young age and whether it will help or not. I think it may have helped, but I'm not convinced from the adult data, research data, which has been published, that this is a magic drug.
And even if doctors don't know whether remdesivir worked, for Emmanuel's family, his recovery was still a stroke of magic.
The nurses were like, Mom, you can sit down. Do you want to give him a... I said, no, I just want to look at the boy lying down because it's a miracle.
A relief for the whole family, including Morris, keeping a close eye on his younger brother, now Britain's youngest COVID-19 survivor.
Emmanuel was discharged from the hospital on May 8th. Which was supposed to be his due date. Emergency rooms across the country saw a significant drop in visits during the last 3 months because of the coronavirus. That's according to a new report from the CDC, which analyzed ER visits from mid-March to the end of May. During that time, researchers found a 23% drop in visits for heart attacks, 20% for stroke, and 10% for uncontrolled high blood sugar. The drop, which took place while most states had stay-home orders, equates to millions of dollars in lost revenue.